So what's going on, people? This is the third year that I've tried to grow a beard, and I have to say, this is actually the longest it's ever been. And I'm pretty proud about that, actually. I've gone through some adversity, as you might expect. Of course, my wife hates it. I've even had some colleagues at work tell me, hey, dude, you gotta trim that up. And these are, you know, the things that you have to deal with in your efforts to grow a beard. There's beard barriers, as I call them. But for the most part, I'm pretty happy. And I say for the most part because I did cave to the pressure several times of trimming up here and trimming down here. But I'm on my Christmas break, and so I can let it fill in and grow a little bit longer to help me out. But in this video, I wanted to talk to you about some of the things that I've noticed and things that I've felt have been beneficial to having a beard and growing a beard. One of the first things that I want to mention is that you got to have a clean face. And that means make sure that when you're in the shower, you actually clean your face. And I use a washcloth and just water. That's all I use. And I really want to make sure that I do some circular motion to make sure that the hair follicles are clear, meaning that I keep them clean and also stimulate the hair follicles by using just a very simple washcloth and water. And on the subject of just water, another thing that I want to mention is that I don't use soap on my face. It's something that I've been doing for a number of years because soap, to me, it just sort of takes away the natural suppleness and softness that your face has. And so I just don't use soap. I just use water, and also I use a washcloth. And you might ask, well, how do you keep your face clean? Well, what I use to clean actually out the dirt is some rose petal infused witch hazel. And I apply that to a cotton ball, and then I just do a circular motion around the areas that need to be cleaned, mainly my neck and my cheeks and my forehead and nose. I don't actually apply that to my beard because any sort of, you know, product that's kind of like alcohol, even though witch hazel is not alcohol, it might make your whiskers a little bit tougher. And an advantage of not washing your face, specifically your beard, is that you're allowing your hair to naturally be conditioned with just the natural oils that God gave us. And so that's one thing that I have felt helps. And another thing is constant brushing with a hairbrush, not like raking your skin, just brushing with a normal brush, making sure that you stimulate the follicles. That's something that I want to return to. Make sure that you stimulate the growth. And a hairbrush does that very nicely. Just some gentle brushing once or twice a day, maybe more if you want to be consistent. But brush your beard. Take good care of it. As far as any oils, you might have noticed, I'm not sure if you've been following my channel, but my hair is getting much longer, and my hair grows very fast. And so I was thinking, maybe I should apply some of the same thinking to my beard as I apply to my hair. And my hair at this point is exactly where I want it to be. And even though this might gross you out, I'm hoping it doesn't. One thing that you should know about my hair is that I also don't use a lot of soap in my hair. I rarely wash my hair. Does that mean I just let it stink and get dirty? No, I do actually, when I'm in the shower, I do what's called the finger style. When I'm underneath the shower head, I'm constantly running my fingers through my hair, scratching my scalp, making sure that there's nothing clinging to it, no dirt in there. And so I'm actually cleaning my hair quite frequently with just water in my fingers, finger style. And it works a number of great ways in that I'm not breaking the curl. If you're constantly brushing and combing out your hair, it's gonna break the curl, and I don't want that. I want a nice little sort of twisted up style going. And so I applied some of that thinking to my beard, and I've noticed that it's helped this third time around in this beard journey. keeping it sort of the same way that I maintain my head of hair. So, but yeah, I feel that's one thing that has helped. I've gone through some stages where I didn't like the patchiness, and so I borrowed one of my wife's eyebrow pencils, black eyebrow pencils, and I actually filled in some of these areas. So on those days where I felt sort of self-conscious about the patchiness, I just use a black eyebrow pencil and it works wonders. I apply like little strokes inside the areas that are patchy, and then I just use a brush to fill it in. Works great, helps me feel better about that patchiness. And then if you feel better about it, then you are okay with letting it grow a little bit more. And so before the end of the year, I wanted to give another video to let you know that I think I've finally figured out how to grow a beard. You gotta sort of do a number of things. First of all, get past those beard barriers, those people that will criticize you and say, oh man, you're looking tacky. You gotta sort of forget about that. And also maintain it, brush it. And my own personal belief is that you should not wash your face with soap, even though to many of you that's going to be strange. It works for me because I don't apply soap to my skin, and so it sort of follows that I'm not gonna apply soap to my beard either. You know, I do clean it with water and a washcloth, but as your beard gets longer, you're gonna notice those whiskers are gonna be really prickly, and the hair on our faces is a lot more coarse than the hair on our heads, and so you gotta do whatever you can to make sure that you keep it supple. Beard oils are great. The same hair conditioner I use in my head, which it has like shea butter and coconut scent, I actually rub that in my face after I shower. And that sort of does the same job that beard oil does. It's specifically designed for me as an African American, and I sort of rub that in my beard. And it works great, smells great. So I'm actually happy with how my beard is going right now. Do I still get criticism? Yes, sure. But it's looking better. And for that, I am glad. We'll continue to update you with the beard process, maybe another video at the end of next year. But I wanted to continue the tradition of one video a year to document my beard journey. But so far, I think third time's the charm. Thank you very much. I hope you have a wonderful holiday and a wonderful 2019. We'll see you again.